Indian armed forces are one among the most powerful defense forces of the world. Not only having the most elite and top-notch personnel that defend our territories on land, sea and air, our armed forces are the largest contributors to the United Nations peacekeeping missions. Hello and welcome, this is BICREC Exams, this is Hemant, and now we will have a brief overview of various important military operations carried out by the armed forces since independence. Before beginning, I would like to tell you that SS BICREC Exams is India's largest, most preferred online defense exams preparatory portal, wherein which you can find the courses for AFCAT, CDS, NDA, Territorial Army, INET exam, Indian Air Force Group X and Group Y. You can even follow us on YouTube, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Telegram, and even directly visit us through our website learn.ssbcrackexams.com. You can even download our app from Google Play Store, wherein which you can get each and every information of the defense forces in your hand. The first important operation that I am going to discuss is about Operation Polo, which was conducted in 1948, wherein which the Indian Armed Forces ended the rule of Nizam of Hyderabad, wherein which the incorporation of the princely state of Hyderabad came into the southern Indian part, into the Indian Union. This has been considered a very important part. According to the Indian Independence Act of 1947, any princely state had its own choice to choose to join into the Pakistani territory or into the Indian dominion. But this particular Hyderabad's Nizam has chosen not to join into any of these, and he tried to be an autonomous ruler. But wherein which, due to the plan of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, and the police army with the Indian army led by Major General J.N. Chowdhury had attacked, and they have covered the Hyderabad, wherein which the Hyderabad's the then ruler Mir Osman Ali Khan, who had a very irregular army of Razakars and he was a very aristocratic ruler, his rule ended by that point of time. The next important operation is about the liberation of Goa, which is named as Operation Vijay of 1961, wherein which the Portugal actually had maintained their own enclaves in Indian subcontinent at Goa, Daman and Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli. All of them they used to collectively call as Estado da India. So they have ended the rule, and this particular operation involved air, sea and land strikes for over 36 hours, and it was a very decisive victory, ending the 451 year rule of Portugal over its remaining exclaves in India. Goa was placed under military administration headed by Kunhimaran Palat Candid as a lieutenant governor. Later it was granted statehood in the year of 1987. The next important operation is about Operation Trident, carried out during the year of 1971. It was done on December 4th and 5th on Pakistan's port city of Karachi during the Indo-Pakistani war, wherein which the Bangladesh came into existence very soon. This particular operation actually saw the first use of anti-ship missiles in this combat region. India suffered no losses. Pakistan actually lost a minesweeper, a destroyer, a cargo vessel carrying ammunition, fuel storage tanks in Karachi and all, and another destroyer was also very badly damaged and eventually scrapped. Since we suffered no losses and the Indian Navy was very, very strong enough here, we celebrate December 4th as Navy Day to celebrate and remark the success of this particular operation. Operation Meghna Heli Bridge was eventually carried out in this same particular war in 1971, wherein which the aerial operation of Indian and Bangladeshi allied forces were involved during the Bangladeshi Liberation War. It actually took place on 9th November while the Indian Air Force lifted the Mukti Bahini and the 4th Corps of Indian Army from Brahman Baria to Raipura in Narsingdi over the river Meghna. That is why this is known as Operation Meghna Heli Bridge, by bypassing the destroyed Meghna Bridge and Pakistani defenses in Ashuganj. Next is about Operation Blue Star, which was done in 1984, where Indian military action carried out between 1st and 8th June to remove militant religious leader Jarnail Singh Bhindranwale and his followers from the buildings of the Harmandir Sahib, the Golden Temple complex of Amritsar in Punjab. This is a very important operation for us because it was actually taken up after a very serious negotiations with the militants by Indira Gandhi. Later, when all of these negotiations failed, she launched this particular operation. Operation Woodrose, it came after the Operation Blue Star, where all different kinds of protests that were happening after the completion of the Blue Star were actually taken down by Operation Woodrose. Operation Meghdoot also was conducted in 1984, where on 13th April 1984, this military operation was actually the first assault launched in the highest battlefield in the world. The moment I say this, your word should be in your mind, it should be Siachen Glacier. So this particular operation involved the occupation of the territory of Siachen Glacier into the Indian subcontinent. This is the area where you can find the Siachen Glacier here. The majority part of Siachen Glacier is actually controlled by the Indian Armed Forces. This is the Aksai Chin and this is the Karakoram range. This is considered Azad Kashmir, but as of now, since the media news agencies and all are reporting very different uses, we can't provide you the proper information regarding this. I will be providing you with a very new special separate video. We will have a very deeper analysis of the situations in Kashmir and the territory there and by then. Next important operation is about Operation Pavan, carried out in the year of 1987, where the operations of Indian Peacekeeping Force IPKF were there to take control of Jaffna from the LTTE, the liberation of Tigers of Tamil Eelam, in the year of 1987 to enforce the disarmament of LTTE as a part of Indo-Sri Lankan Accord. As a part of Indo-Sri Lankan Accord, the LTTE was asked to abandon all of its arms and ammunitions, but the LTTE denied to do so. Many different sort of negotiations were done, but at the end, the Indian Army and the Indian Armed Forces have thought that if they didn't listen, then it has to be done by force, and this Operation Pavan came into existence by then. The more important thing was Operation Virat, which actually occurred 1 year later in 1988. After Operation Pavan was an anti-insurgency operation launched by Indian Peacekeeping Force against LTTE in April in northern Sri Lanka. Operation Trishul and Operation Checkmate were also the operations after this which were conducted. According with Operation Virat, this anti-insurgency operation of Operation Trishul was again launched by IPKF against this in April in northern Sri Lanka. In 1988, it was launched by Operation Checkmate. Next important operation is about Operation Cactus. Para commandos of Indian Army and Marine commandos of Indian Navy ousted the Tamil nationalist mercenaries of People's Liberation Organization of Tamil Eelam, who instigated a coup in Mali in Maldives. So this involves operation in Maldives. Next important operation is about Operation Vijay of 1999. The moment you see this here, your mind should flicker about the Kargil war. Indian operation to push back the infiltrators from the Kargil sector involved in the Kargil war. Operation Safed Sagar was an operation which was launched by the Indian Air Force to help the Indian Armed Forces, Indian Army, who was conducting the Operation Vijay. Indian Air Force role was here to actually oust, to flush out all regular and irregular troops of the Pakistani Army from vacated Indian positions in the Kargil sector along the line of control. It was a very first large scale use of air power in the Jammu and Kashmir region since the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971. Operation Black Tornado and Operation Cyclone were done in the incidents of Mumbai 26/11. 10 members of Lashkar-e-Taiba, an extremist Islamist terrorist organization which was based in Pakistan, it carried out 12 coordinated shooting and bombing attacks lasting 4 days across Mumbai. So this operation was a very strategic and very, very detailed one. The attacks actually began on 26th of November and lasted until Saturday 29th of November. In this particular disaster, 174 people have died, including 9 attackers, and more than 300 were wounded. The most important armed forces that included in this particular operation were the National Security Guards and various Indian Armed Forces. Next important operation is about Operation Surya Hope, which was conducted in the year of 2013 during the Uttarakhand floods. To go more in detail of some of the operations, which include Operation All Out in 2015, which involved the flushing out of all militants from Jammu and Kashmir region. Operation Maitri, which was conducted in 2015 as a relief and rescue mission in earthquake hit Nepal. Operation Goodwill, which was begun in 1998 and is still continuing, which involves the humanitarian tasks in Jammu and Kashmir. Operation Good Samaritan involves the humanitarian task in Manipur and Nagaland, which is still continuing. The Indo-Pak military confrontation of 2016, which includes the surgical strike in across 2 to 3 kilometers of Pakistan occupied Kashmir. The Yuri movie is actually based on this particular operation. Operation Sahyog of 2018 also involves to rescue the people in flood hit Kerala, and there are many more operations. With this, I have covered the most important military operations that have to be remembered for you regarding various defense examinations and for the case of SSB interviews and all. I hope so that this particular video will be very helpful to you. Please subscribe to SSB Crack Exams. Stay home, stay safe, and Jai Hind.